Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to get into the Suicide Boys style. Now at first I thought just by their name that they were going to be, you know, presenting a message that I wasn't really cool with. Maybe I just heard the wrong song. Regardless of the lyric, I like the way they present it. It's like rock slash trap. And I think any hybrid for trap right now is really exciting because trap has so much potential. I mean, hip hop culture has created some of the best genre ever, as well as house and parts of EDM as well. So those are like the budding genres, and it's really fun to know that people are continuously pushing trap. So their style is very simplistic, but it's all about the vocal performance. So the beat kind of takes a back seat. So always remember that for their style. They're very, very creative when it comes to vocal melodies, and they have a very unique style of songwriting. And that's the cool part. So let's open up. I'm going to keep this Nexus based. So let's open up Nexus, and we're going to create a nice haunted sounding piano melody. Now we're going to see these recurring themes in trap music, like a four note melody, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, you know, but if you listen to horror music and the film score, it's very repetitive in the melody. And that's where some of these horror melodies in trap came from, the horror genre in film score. So let's go to piano. Let's go to just a simple grand piano. Now this one has like a knock, which I don't like. Like every key has a thud to it. So what I might do is turn on the master filter, change it to a high pass filter, which means we're cutting out low frequencies, and simply pull down your cutoff frequency knob. I just want to EQ out that thud. I just don't like that thud that comes with some grand pianos. So for their melodies, they don't use a lot of it's not like a bass octave and then high octaves. You know, it's not like that. It's more like, I think that's a melody from "About Me," actually, by Wiz Khalifa. So you know, there's ways to get around sounding repetitive, like somebody else's song, because it's only four notes in a melody. So it's kind of like, how do you not copy four notes? I mean, just by happenstance, you could accidentally copy somebody's melody. So I don't know how tight the restrictions are on that front, but let's open up the piano roll. We're gonna make two parts of the melody. One's gonna be kind of this range, and then the next melody is gonna be an octave higher. So those are going to be the change-ups for the melody, so it doesn't get too repetitive, because it can get too repetitive, trust me. So let's tap out the tempo. So we're at about 108, which is a dance tempo, but we can turn this into trap. Trap isn't a BPM. It's a way of producing drums called halftime drums. Some people call it double time. Whatever you call it, it's the perception of making your drums feel as if they're slowed down to a tempo that's not the tempo at hand, like 108, but the drums will feel like half the tempo, 54 BPM. So I'll show you how to do that next. But let's start with the melody. Let's just do one thing at a time. So where are we at? Which octave are we in? So instead of copying the "About Me" melody from Wiz Khalifa, let's come up with something unique. Let's just start randomly on a random note that you'd like to hear. I think that sounds haunted. Just that note A, for some reason with the reverb, sounds haunted. Now what I'm gonna do, what's gonna separate you from a lot of people, is to create your melody so that it's mimicking the sustain pedal on your piano. So if I hold the sustain pedal on my keyboard and I play a chord, I don't have to touch the notes anymore. It's just playing the notes. So if I play a whole bunch of notes, they're really overlapping. And that's how you get that really nice sound of a piano. It's when they hold the sustain pedal. That's one of my videos on the most secret weapon. I forget what it's called, but the sustain pedal is a super duper soaker, and it will soak people up. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to emulate that. So let's do four note melody. If I get the creative bug, I might go longer than four notes, but so our goal is to make the sound haunted as possible. If you want to make haunted melodies easily, just use half steps, meaning one note to the next note above or below. That creates the haunted sound. So I'm going to repeat this, but for me, I just, there's something about deep in my brain saying I hate too much repetition. You can overkill repetition easily. It's kind of like sending your girlfriend the same happy birthday card over and over and over again. It gets boring. So let's change up a note here. I'm gonna pull this up to the note above, so it's a half step away from A. So four note, hold on as the screen glitches real quick. Four note melodies are usually the favorite. Whoa, that is scary. I stopped at 666. That is freaky. Oh my God. Wow. My eyes teared up because that was weird. I'll admit that was weird. And if it's 6 minutes and 66 seconds in the video, that's even weirder. That's scary. So now let's go to the playlist. Let's right click. Let's go to pattern one. And should I continue this video right now? Okay, so let's add that into the playlist. Let's mimic the sustain pedal, which I forgot to do. We're gonna simply elongate the notes. So we're gonna pull out the note values to reach for the whole bar. You can have them continue on if you want to emulate a real sustain pedal. I'm gonna treat this as if it were a sample, so it's gonna have to restart. But if you wanted to create the effect of a real sustain pedal, you'd continue the elongation of notes. So it looks something like this if you played it with a sustain pedal. It looks chaotic, but all we're doing is just stretching out the notes towards the next note. And that's all, until it plays again. That 666 thing was so creepy. I'm still thinking about that. Wow, that's freaky. Okay. But the message that I'm going to do for the songwriting is not going to be about slitting wrist or whatever I heard in one of their songs. So let's... So really we're holding that tone. We're treating the tone as if it were its own reverb. So that's how I like to think of it. It's its own coloration. So that's our main piano melody. Now for me, I'm gonna just go to the Nexus. I'm gonna turn up what's called pre-delay, just a little bit, and then turn up the decay time of the reverb. I'm also gonna cut out low frequencies just in case it's creating low frequencies in the reverb. And then I'm gonna turn up the mix level just a bit. So I'm creating these really long tailed notes. So instead of just playing, you know, a short little note, it lasts a lot longer. I'm gonna add a very subtle delay. Okay. Now let's split it up, have the second half of the melody go up an octave. It can even do something different. So here in the playlist, all I have to do is go to the top left, make unique, so it creates a new pattern with the same information, same MIDI data. And you could change this source pattern to pattern 2 as well. And let's go into pattern 2 in our channel rack. Just click inside the piano roll. And let's hit control up to move this up an octave. So it's the same exact melody, just up an octave. And that's another technique in horror music to go... Wait, sorry. I'm trying to play live, so... It just introduces a creepy element. Very high-pitched pianos are very, very creepy because they're used in a lot of creepy genres. Okay, so now we need to, before we get to the drums, I'm trying to write in the music first. I think the piano is going to take up the majority, and then the vocals are going to play the melodic other half. So the vocals are going to do most of the work. Now let's start with the 808, because the 808, I want it to have a specific rhythm. I'm going to start with the 808 and the hi-hats. Let's go to pattern 3. Let's open up our browser, which is already open. Let's go to busyworksbeats.com. Let's open up the 808 Science drums, and let's find a decent 808 for this specific song, because they're not all the same. So let's see. There's a good one. 808 Alkaline, because it has a short body, which we need for its transient energy, and it's also a saturated sound, meaning it has upper harmonics, excuse me, which is going to add to the you know, the energetic sound. So let's right click, let's edit, let's go to the marker tab, and let's detect pitch regions just to see what the pitch of this 808 is. So you're like, okay, should I go with A or G sharp? I say go with the longer pitch. So let's do G sharp. And if it sounds off, we can always change it. So let's reset, let's right click on G sharp. So now our 808 is roughly tuned. Again, if you want more information on tuning, type in Tuning BusyWorks Beats. I'll go in depth in that video as to how to tune more properly. Now we just need drums. So I'm pretty sure they have the X drums. Let's go to X drums because they use the snare out of here. So that's fine. So let's right click. This is the hardest snare in the history of life. I've never heard a harder snare than this snare here. So my headphones are quite loud. So let me turn this down because it's super loud in my headphones. So here's how we're going to start programming double time or halftime drums, whatever you want to say. Double time is the tempo, halftime are the drums. It doesn't matter. It's a relative experience anyway. We're going to put the snare on the 3 and the 7. So that means every time the metronome hits, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we're going to put it on the 3 and the 7. So 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that's how we do halftime drums. So usually you would put it on the 2 and the 4. So it goes 1, 2, you know, 1, 2, 3, tour, you know, that's the typical snare, but we're going to put it on the 3 and the 7. So now the drums feel like they're half the BPM. So we just need to add an 808 pattern. So let me add the snares in. So they're doing their own thing. And we might as well add a kick since we're right here. Let's go to kicks. But I don't want to get too crazy with the kick because I want the 808 to be heard first. Because I don't even think they have a kick, actually. Let me see. Actually, in the song I'm referencing, they didn't use a kick. So they're just using 808 for the energy of the low end. And we need a hi-hat. So let's open up the browser again. xdrums@busyworksbeats.com/x, the letter X. Go to hi-hats. I'm just going to use hi-hat X, which works 99.9% of the time for trap beats. Let's hit Control S. Let's go to pattern 4. I'm going to create a hi-hat roll for the rhythm, and then I'm going to produce the 808. So the hi-hat, in my opinion, dictates the rhythm of the majority of the drums. So I like to focus on that first and then add the other drums because they're kind of relative. So I'm going to do a lot of glitchy hi-hats. I'm going to show you how to do that pretty simply. So let me come up with a rhythm in my head, and then I'm going to translate it. Okay, so let's do that. So I want to go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So let's do that. Then I want to glitch right here. So let's right click, piano roll. Change your snap to grid to 1/2 step. Drag out this note here, highlight it, hitting Control, left click and highlight, and then hit Control U to slice it according to your snap to grid. So if you change it to a quarter step, it'll slice it into quarter steps instead of half steps. So if that's too slow, which it is, I'm gonna go to quarter step now, and this is gonna re-slice it. So a lot of people try to switch it to like 1/3 step and then slice it again. It slices whatever is there. So it's gonna slice the stuff that was sliced. Okay, I know that sounds confusing, but you'll see if you wanna change time signatures or whatever, I'd suggest just hitting Control Z, going back and then re-slicing it from that one long note rather than trying to slice over a slice. So let's hit Control U one more time. So I want this to stop a little bit earlier. So let me figure out where I want it to stop. I want it to stop right around here. So I don't want it to hold, you know, it's just too long. Ta 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 ta. So now it's in piano roll view because we're out of the sequencer because we're using such small note sizes. So right here, I want it to go into what's called triplet timing. So let's go to snap to grid. I'm gonna go to 1/3 beat. That will change my whole grid to a different measure called 3/4 timing. And that goes ta 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 ta. So it's like 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. It's a certain counting versus 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. It goes 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So that's, you know, another trick for trap. If you want to add a little more tension, you could always switch to triplet timing every now and then. and it just adds a nice contrast. So I forgot the rest of the pattern, so I'm just gonna duplicate it. So I wanna go 1, 2, tzz. So I'm gonna drag this note out and hit Control U. And remember, it's gonna slice to your snap to grid, so I have it on half step. That's good enough. I'm not gonna sit here and spend too much time with the hi-hats. You could also go back and take out hi-hats in between. So it doesn't have to be like 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2. It could just be 1, 2, 2, tzz, you know. So let's do that. Let's leave a couple gaps in here so it's not too repetitive. Your hi-hats are going to dictate how we listen to the track and how we perceive the groove. It's a very important element in trap music, especially if you're using a lot of hi-hat roll glitches. Okay, so we have our snare, we have our hi-hats, we need an 808, and we need vocals, and I'm trying to think, what else did we leave out? I think we're good after we add the 808. 808 is going to be very steady and stable. We might do an 808 slide or two, but for the most part, it's going to be one note. So let's just come up with a nice rhythm, then we can go back and add the notes. So right now, it's out of key because it's playing the note C right now. We're just trying to come up with a decent rhythm. So they have a lot of doom, you know, a lot of stuttering 808. So let's go to piano roll. We're gonna go back to 1/3 beat. And we're gonna create those stuttering triplet sections. So that's how they get that kind of rock style. They switch over to triplet timing and then come back to quarter timing. So that's what gives you that kind of off balance effect. Let's pull this up to a proper note. So it should be G sharp, I believe. I could be wrong. Where's the piano start? Let's see. Piano starts at A. Okay. A-okay. All right. Let's pull this down a couple octaves. Control up or control down. That's too low, so let's pull it up another octave. So I'm not going to, you know, make 1,000 808 patterns. I'm just going to clone it and change a little something about pattern 6. Sorry for the piano, it just plays the MIDI. So let's add a slight roll, for example. I'm just gonna clone a note, change this snap to grid back to a half step. Forgot to do that first. Clone a note over. In FL Studio, you can double click a note and change it to a slide note. You can also do the same thing if you turn on what's called portamento functionality in your sampler, however you're programming your 808. Go to your settings in whatever plugin, go to portamento in FL Studio, it's under the wrench tool, turn on portamento and turn up your slide parameter or your glide parameter. This will tell it the pitch bend between two notes. And if you turn on mono mode, this means it'll only play one note at a time, which is something you want. So now if I play two notes, it pitch bends between those. So you don't necessarily need the FL Studio slide functionality. It's just doing portamento based on your MIDI. So I'm gonna go boom, boom. So I'm gonna pull this down an octave. Now that might be too low. So one of these notes I'm gonna pull up a half step. So I'm gonna pull that one up a half step, hit shift up. Let's do two notes half step. Add another slide just so it has a lot of bending going on. And that's pretty much it. Now you just have to add a decent vocal melody. So that's the other side of the songwriting. It's not just the beat, it's also your songwriting capability. So I'll add like a, you know, I call it grunge because that's a word I just have in my mind, but like a dark style vocal with aggression in it. turn that hi-hat down. So their style is like when you do the vocal take, which I'm going to do aside outside of this video, but I'm going to show you the end result. You want to do three takes, pan one left, pan one center, and pan one right. You could do slight variations, but for the most part, they're saying the same stuff. They're just doing multiple takes and then panning one hard left, hard right, and then panning one vocal center, all doing the same verse. And that's what creates that big wide vocal. And also they're very creative with their, you know, their tones and the stuff. So you got to be creative here. And also you can learn vocal mixing at busyworksbeats.com. So there's a lot there for you. So let's move into the second half where we add the vocal melody. Thank you for watching today. If you want to learn more about the core of this, especially melody, go to busyworksbeats.com/melody magic. There are specific parameters around melody that you need to learn in order to create better melodies, because I get the question all the time, how do you make melodies so quickly, or how do I make them off the top of my head? There's a workflow to it. There's a thought process. Once you learn it, you're never going to forget it. So go to busyworksbeats.com/melody magic. Thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com. Focus all deep in a lab room smoking.
Genie, show up, grant wishes, then I'm out, bitches. Y'all niggas what I'm about, in the mosh pit, throwing elbows out. You ain't bout it, you ain't bout it, doubt it. 100 grand large, with it all by my team at large. Yeah, I'm feeling kinda like Marge, blue top on the dot, that's ours. Shit, I've been back up the cars, trying to lift them up, dropping on SARS. Yeah, off the planet like Mars, y'all nigga what they know about ours.
Create complete compositions with comprehension. Master music theory. Visit busyworksbeats.com/music theory for your free bonuses and free music theory tutorials. Professional mixing secrets finally revealed. Get 3 free videos straight from the new Mixing Academy complete course package at busyworksbeats.com/mac. Want to learn how to make beats like the pros?
Join now for free at busyworksbeats.com and learn the secrets of the pros.